Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss about parallel AC circuits. So let us start with a simple circuit. First I am starting with parallel RL circuit. So that means the resistor is connected in parallel with an inductor. So I am taking a resistor R, let us assume inductor is L. This is connected to some supply, AC supply. So let us assume the AC supply I am taking as a reference. So this will be V maximum sin omega t. Because of that, the current I will pass. This current will divide among the resistor IR and as well as the current through the inductor. Okay. So I am just representing this V is equal to V maximum sin omega t. So we can tell that the total current I is the sum of the current through the resistor and the current through the inductor. Or this I can directly write, let us assume the total impedance I can represent by V divided by some resistance, sorry, some impedance. So this I can write as V by R plus IL is 1 by L into integration of V dt. We already know this. Or this, if you are substituting, this will become V maximum sin omega t divided by R minus V maximum by omega L into cos omega t. So this I can write as V maximum sin omega t divided by R plus V maximum by omega L. So this I can write of the form sin of omega t minus 90 degrees, because this is cos minus cos. So if you are taking, this is my sinusoidal wave, so minus cos wave will be like this. That means you can see this second wave is lagging by 90 degrees, lagging behind this by 90 degrees. This angle will be 90 degrees. This is my the value of the current that is passing through the inductor. So that is the reason I have written sin of omega t minus 90 degrees, indicating it is lagging. So this I can write as V maximum. This is one term, this is second term. So I want to write in the form V maximum of sin of omega t plus phi or omega t minus phi. So I am directly writing the answer what will come. We will try to solve it for the case of RLC parallel circuit so that it will be clear to you. So if you write it, this will be of the form 1 by R square plus 1 by omega L whole square. This will be the product multiplied by V maximum sin of omega t minus phi. You will get it this form. So similar way, if you solve for the case of parallel RC circuit, instead of inductor, if some capacitor is there, how it will come? Again, same thing, I am taking some voltage. So this is my R and this is my C. There is a current passing through the resistor, current passing through the capacitor. So same way I can write I is equal to IR plus IC. So this one I can write as through the resistor, it will be same V by R plus C into dV by dt. That will give my current through the capacitor. So this will become V maximum by R sin omega t plus V maximum by 1 by omega C into sin of omega t plus 90 degrees. Sin of omega t plus 90 degrees. Because if you write this C into dV by dt, you will write as d by dt of sin omega t. D by dt of sin omega t will become, this one will become omega C into cos omega t. So actually how this came? This came because this omega C I can write 1 divided by 1 by omega C and cos omega t. Cos omega t means if you are taking this as sinusoidal signal, this is my cosine signal. So cosine signal will have the 0 before, or we can tell this current is leading by 90 degrees. This is my current IC. So that is the reason I have written sin omega t plus 90 degrees. So this I can write as 1 by R whole square plus omega C square into V maximum sin of omega t plus phi. So how this term is coming, we are going to solve in the case of RLC parallel circuit, because in one go how to calculate all will be clarified to you. So let us go to parallel RLC circuit. Parallel RLC means there is a resistance also, there is one inductance also, and there is one capacitance also. Now if you apply the AC, so how it is going to behave, that we are going to see. So I can calculate my current I is equal to IR plus IL plus IC. So this I can write as V by R plus 1 by L into integration of V dt plus C into dV by dt. So I can write like this. So if you substitute the value of V, this becomes V maximum sin omega t divided by R plus 1 by L into integration of VDT. Integration of sin omega t will be minus cos omega t by omega. So this becomes minus 1 by omega L into cos omega t. Similarly, C into dV by dt, d by dt of sin omega t will be equal to omega into cos omega t. So this will become omega into C into V maximum cos omega t. So this I can write as V maximum divided by R sin omega t plus omega C minus 1 by omega L V maximum cos omega t. So this is my total current I. So let us assume the total current I want to write of the form A into sin of omega t plus phi. That means sin A plus B. I can write of the form sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. So this I can write as sin omega t into cos phi plus A times of cos omega t into sin phi. I can write it in this form. So I can compare this equation with this equation. Let us take it as equation number 1. So if you compare this, so first equation has sin omega t. So remaining term is A cos phi. So I can tell that A cos phi is equal to V maximum by R. Similarly, from the second one, cos omega t is common. So I can get this as A sin phi will be equal to omega C minus 1 by omega L. And I forgot to write V is also there, right? So V maximum I am writing here. So V maximum into omega C minus 1 by omega L. So I can calculate my value of A. A is equal to, take the square on both sides, A square cos square pi plus A square sin square pi. Cos square plus sin square will become 1. So A square will be there. From this I can calculate my value of A. A will be equal to 1 by R square plus omega C minus 1 by omega L whole square into V maximum. This is my value of A I am getting. So from this I can calculate my value of current I. This A will be 1 by R square plus omega C minus 1 by omega L whole square into V maximum sin of omega t plus phi. This is how it came. This is my total current. But you can see here, calculating in this way is very complex and will be very difficult task. Only I want to introduce to you how to solve in a conventional way for the parallel circuit. So let us see what will be the easier way to solve the parallel circuit. So solving parallel circuits using admittance and phasor algebra. I am going to use the admittance method and parallel algebra. So let us see, I am taking one voltage source V, because practically only pure resistor, pure inductor or pure capacitor will not be there. Always inductor or resistor will have the combination of resistance plus inductance. Always capacitance may have either shunt resistance or the series resistance with it. Always the combination will be there. That's why I don't know what is there in the block. I am just representing with the blocks only. Let us assume there are 3 blocks. So let us assume this block is having impedance Z1, this has Z2 and this has Z3. So let us assume this is current I1, this is current I2, this is current I3, total current is I. So from this circuit I can calculate I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So how can I calculate this? So I is nothing but V by the total impedance will be equal to V by Z1, that is current I1, I2 will be V by Z2. And I3 will be V by Z3, because same voltage is applying across each parallel path. So from this I can write 1 by Z is equal to 1 by Z1 plus 1 by Z2 plus 1 by Z3. So this 1 by Z is called as the admittance. So this admittance will be equal to 1 by Z1 will be Y1, 1 by Z2 is Y2 plus 1 by Z3 is Y3. That means using the Z you have to calculate the admittance. If you calculate the admittance, you can directly add it, that will be the advantage. And so if you want to calculate the current I is V by Z or simply V into Y. Just taking the product of V into Y, I can calculate the admittance. So practically the admittance will be represented as a sum of G minus or plus into JB, where G is the conductance and B is susceptance. This minus sign will come for the case of inductive circuit and plus sign will come for the case of capacitive circuit. That means a circuit having capacitor and an inductor. So let us try to solve different circuits using this admittance technique so that whatever I am discussing will be clear to you. So first I am taking the case of the circuit that is having a pure resistor in parallel with a pure inductor. This is XL, this is R. There is current I1, I2 and total current is I. Applied voltage is V. So I can write my current I is equal to I1 plus I2, or I can write this V by Z is equal to V by R plus V by J times of XL. I am just representing in phasor form. So this I can write as V by R. This J is there in the denominator. I can multiply both numerator and denominator with J. That means product and division. J into J become J square. J square is nothing but minus 1. So this sign becomes minus J times of V by XL. Or this I can separate out V into 1 by R minus J by XL. This is V by Z. So V by Z, 1 by Z I can write as V into Y. So I can tell that Y is equal to 1 by R minus J divided by XL. So this is nothing but G and this is nothing but B. Or otherwise we can tell that RL circuit in parallel, I can write Y is equal to G minus JB, where G is equal to 1 by R and B is equal to 1 by XL. So that means for one circuit I got 1 by R, another circuit is 90 degrees leading, I got 1 by XL. So if you draw the diagram, if you are taking your voltage as reference, this V into G, because this I can write as V into G minus J times of V into B, that will give my total. So V into G, this is nothing but the current through the resistor. Similarly, current through the inductor will be equal to V into B. It is written as minus J, that's why I have taken minus 90 degrees. This resultant will give my current I is equal to V into Y. Let us assume this angle is phi. So from this I can calculate my angle phi is equal to tan inverse of Y component. Y component will be B and the X component is R. Tan inverse of B by R. This is one way, or otherwise I can get my power factor cos phi. Cos phi is equal to R divided by, sorry, this is R is not there, this is G. So G divided by Y, this will give my power factor in this case. So let us see another case. I am taking the case of a resistor in parallel with a capacitor. R is there, XC is there. Let us assume this is I1, this is my value of I2. The current I is passing, V is applied. So again, same way I can calculate I is equal to I1 plus I2. So this I can write as V by Z is equal to V by R plus V by minus JXC. Because we know in the capacitor, whatever is there, capacitive reactance is represented by minus 90 degrees. If you have the doubt of this, you can refer to my previous class where I have discussed the application of phasor algebra to AC circuits. So there I have discussed this, how this minus J comes. So then this I can write as V into 1 by R. So this J I can multiply with numerator and denominator with J divided by J. J into J, J square is minus 1, minus into minus becomes plus. So this becomes minus into minus becomes plus J divided by XC. So this is V by Z. Or from this I can write Y is equal to V into Y is equal to V into G plus JB, where the value of G is equal to 1 by R and B is equal to, B will be equal to 1 by XC. So you can see here, for capacitive reactance I am getting plus J and for inductive reactance I am getting minus J. So this I can represent in voltage form also. This is my voltage phasor I am taking as reference. This V into G will be in phase with it and the second component is J times of V into B. This gives my resultant value. This is V into Y. This is my total current. This current is leading by some angle in the case of capacitor circuit. And formula for cos phi and phi will be same like before. So let us take the practical case. So practically I know that no element will be pure resistive or pure inductive or capacitive. Always there will be a combination. Let us try to solve this in the case of combination. So I am taking the combination of R1 and C1, a combination which is having the resistor and capacitor. And let us assume the second branch is having a resistance in series with an inductor. So this is my current I2, this is my current I1, total current is I. So this I can write as I is equal to I1 plus I2, or from this I can write V by Z is equal to V by Z1 plus V by Z2. So let us try to substitute from this. This is V divided by what is Z1? Z1 we have already know that in series circuits, this I can represent as R1 minus J times of XC1. Because for XC I have to take as minus sign, we have seen in phasor algebra, plus V divided by R plus J XL2. This is R2 plus J XL2. For the case of inductor, that J will be plus, because the voltage drop across inductor is leading by 90 degrees, voltage drop across capacitor is lagging by 90 degrees, that is why minus comes here. Or from this I can write V by Z is equal to this V, I am just taking out, this is having minus J. I want to remove all the imaginary components in the denominator, so I have to multiply both numerator and denominator with its conjugate. The meaning of conjugate means only imaginary component sign will change or the angle sign will change. So in this case, this becomes 1 by R1 minus JXC1. I am multiplying with conjugate. That means R1 plus JXC1 divided by R1 plus JXC1 plus 1 by R2 plus JXL2 into R2 minus JXC2 divided by R2 minus JXC2. I am just multiplying and dividing. So this will become R1 divided by A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. So J square, J square will become minus 1. Minus into minus becomes plus. This becomes R1 square plus XC1 square plus J times of XC1 divided by R1 square plus XC1 square. And this component becomes R2 divided by R2 square plus XL2 square minus J times of XL2 divided by R2 square minus plus XL2 square. Remember this, this is L2. This may be confusion. I am taking the multiplying and dividing with the conjugate. So this I can combine the terms. So this becomes R1. This is real component, this is real component, these two will add, similar is the imaginary part. So this V by Z I can represent as V into Y. This I can represent as, this one is nothing but real component is G, so I can write this as G1, and this is B1, this is G2, and this is B2. So this I can write as G1 plus JB1, this is for the case of capacitive, and for inductive we will get as G2 minus JB2. Minus will come for inductive and plus will come for capacitive. Just remember this so that you will not make mistake. This we have to multiply with V. So V is missing here. So I can write V into Y is equal to V into G1 plus G2 plus J times of B1 plus, that B2 is negative. So I am just taking it inside. So this I can write as V into G plus JB. I can write in this form. So I can tell that the total conductance will be the sum of conductance of each one. Similarly, total susceptance will be sum of the susceptance of each of the susceptances. So I can write in this form. And or I can write that Y is nothing but the sum of the admittances, Y1 plus Y2. So where Y1 is G plus G1 plus JB1 and Y2 is G2 plus JB2. So in this way I can calculate this. So how to calculate the angle? So angle will be equal to same thing like before, tan inverse of, because this will be G and B can be plus or minus. For the case of capacitor it will be plus, for the case of inductor it will be negative, but the angle will be same. So this will be Y. So tan inverse of Y divided by X. So what is the angle, plus or minus? It depends on whether B is positive or B is negative. If B is negative, angle will be negative. If B is positive, angle will be positive. You have to remember that. Now similar way, if you want to calculate the power, power I can calculate as V into I into cos phi. Either you can calculate from this, or this I can write as V into I can write as V into Y, and cos phi I can write G by Y. So this becomes V square into G. This is one way to solve this. There is another way to solve. This I can solve using polar form. How to solve using polar form? So let us assume my value of Z1 in the current example is R1 minus GXC1. So let us convert to the polar form. Polar form, it will become Z1 at an angle of minus phi 1. Similarly, I can write my value of Z2 is equal to R2 plus JXL2. This I can write as some angle Z2, angle will be positive. So we know the total admittance is equal to Y1 plus I2. This will be equal to Y at an angle of plus or minus phi, because adding admittances is easy. So how to calculate this admittance? So this admittance I can calculate as Y1 will be equal to 1 by Z1. 1 by Z1 means this will become 1 by Z1. That angle will come in the numerator, this will become plus phi 1. That means magnitude, this is Y1 at an angle of phi 1, where the magnitude of Y1 is equal to 1 by Z1. So similar way, I can calculate my Y2 is equal to 1 by Z2. This will be Y2 at an angle of minus phi 2, because angle when coming to numerator becomes minus, where the value of Y2 is equal to 1 by Z2. This will be the magnitude. So now Y1, Y2 come, we can calculate the value of sum of Y is equal to Y1 plus Y2. That angle can be plus or minus. So once Y is obtained, I can calculate the value of I is equal to V into Y, and power P I can calculate by V square into G. In this way I can solve. I hope this is clear to you. I am sure you will have some little bit confusions. So these, to remove these confusions, we have to solve some numericals. So as it takes more time, so I am preparing as a separate lecture. So in next class I am going to discuss the numericals on this parallel AC circuits, so that whatever doubts you have, those doubts will be clarified. I will try to solve 3 to 4 numericals. If you have specific doubts about this topic, you can please leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.